Law 22. Use the surrender tactic. Transform weakness into power. When you are weak, never fight for honor's sake. Instead, choose surrender. Surrender gives you time to recover, time to wait for his power to wane. Do not give him the satisfaction of fighting and defeating you. Surrender first. By turning the other cheek, you infuriate and unsettle him. Make surrender a tool of power. Three reasons to surrender. The first one. No one comes to help a weaker adversary. They will not put themselves in danger. In classical times, the city of Athens dominated the sea and coastal areas around Greece. The island of Melos was situated in the heart of the Mediterranean, which the Athenians wanted to conquer. The Melians refused to ally themselves with Athens and remained loyal to their original colonizer, Sparta. In 416 BC, the Athenians sent an expedition against Melos. Before launching an all-out attack, however, they dispatched a delegation to persuade the Melians to surrender and become an ally, rather than suffer defeat. The Melians argued how authority belonged to the gods and exclaimed their assurances that Sparta would come to their defense. The Athenians countered that the Spartans were conservative, practical people, and they would not help Melos because they had nothing to gain and a lot to lose by doing so. "Do not be led astray by a false sense of honor," said the Athenians. The debate ended. The Melians discussed the issue among themselves and decided to trust in the aid of the Spartans, the will of the gods, and the righteousness of their cause. They politely declined the Athenians' offer. A few days later, the Athenians invaded Melos. After a brave last stand, the Melians were defeated. The Spartans did not come to their rescue. The Athenians put to death all the men of military age, sold the women and children as slaves, and repopulated the island with their own colonists. Interpretation. The Melians let their honor and pride blind them to the rationality and tact behind surrendering. The second reason. Lulling your enemy into complacency gives you the time to recoup, undermine, and revenge. In 473 BC, in ancient China, King Gaozhen of Yu suffered a horrible defeat from the ruler of Wu and went to work in his conqueror's stables as the lowest servant. For 3 years he humbled himself before the ruler, who then, finally satisfied with his loyalty, allowed him to return home. Inwardly, however, Gaozhen had spent those 3 years gathering information and plotting revenge. When the kingdom was weakened by inner turmoil, he raised an army, invaded, and won with ease. That is the power behind surrender. It gives you time and flexibility to plot a devastating counterblow. The third reason. When you are weak, there's nothing to gain by fighting a useless fight. If you find yourself temporarily weakened, the surrender tactic is perfect for raising yourself up again. It disguises your ambition. It teaches you patience and self-control, key skills in the game, and it puts you in the best possible position for taking advantage of your oppressor's sudden slide. Retreat in the face of a strong enemy is a sign not of weakness but of strength. By resisting the temptation to respond to an aggressor, you buy yourself valuable time. Time to recover, to think, to gain perspective. Let your enemies advance. Time is more important than space. Power is always in flux, since the game is by nature fluid and an arena of constant struggle. Those with power almost always find themselves eventually on the downward swing. Reversal. Retreat must never be an end in itself. Those who genuinely surrender give up their freedom. You have to remember that you only appear to surrender, like the animal that plays dead to save its hide. At some point you have to turn around and fight. Combat is, in the long run, unavoidable. Thank you.